Hi, my name is Brianna Alfaro, and I am Soulfire Farms Soil Carbon Field Researcher. Today I'm going to share with you a few ways to test your soil for indicators of soil health and soil carbon. This is part two of a two-part series that demonstrates how to conduct in-field soil health tests. In the first video, we looked at how to perform an earthworm count, an infiltration test, and a slake test. This video showcases the Munsell soil color test, the microbiometer field test, the Solvita soil respiration test, and the soil hardness test. The tests in part one required tools and materials you can find around a farm, a household, or a hardware store. The tests in this video require materials or equipment from specialty stores or scientific labs, which can all be ordered online. In some cases, you might be able to borrow equipment from a local agricultural service provider. For example, a local extension office may have a penetrometer for the soil hardness test or a Munsell soil color card that they can offer to loan you. Similar to the tests in video one, the tests in this video can help you understand the quality of your soil, and we know that healthy soils with higher levels of organic matter also have more carbon. As far as choosing when and where to perform these tests, the same guidance as explained in video one holds true. Spring and fall are most ideal, and 2 or 3 days after a significant rain in most cases. For the Munsell soil color test, the microbiometer test, and soil respiration test, you'll gather multiple samples of your soil to represent the area that you're interested in. You'll mix them and you'll take a sample from the mixture. This is also known as a composite sample. Each of the tests has slightly different instructions regarding how many individual samples to take to make up your mixture, as well as different depths from which to sample. I'll go over these instructions while I'm walking you through each test. Similarly, the soil hardness test tells us the most when we take multiple readings and calculate an average. In most cases, these tests can be performed by one person, but it can be helpful, and it's way more fun to do them with someone else. If you are part of a farming team or farming community, I recommend sharing the experience of learning the story of your soil with others. Before you begin testing, record as many details about the location of your test site as possible so that you can retest in the same location in future years. It's also helpful to record details about the weather and the management history so that you can try to test under similar conditions in years to come. In this test, we use color as an indicator for organic matter. Organic matter is the portion of the soil that comes from living matter, including plants and small organisms that are alive or decomposing, and black humus, which is the decomposed material. Organic matter is where we find soil carbon. Dark organic matter enters the soil from the surface and becomes part of the soil layers below, bringing nutrients and dark color pigments with it. Most organic matter is found within the top 8 or so inches, and this is the depth from which we'll take our samples. In this test, a sample of soil is held next to a Munsell soil color chart to find a visual match and is assigned a corresponding Munsell notation. To perform the Munsell color test, you will need a soil knife or a trowel for digging out a sample, a small bucket or container for collecting soil, a spray bottle with water if the soil is dry, and a Munsell soil color chart. The Munsell soil color chart 2-pack can be purchased through the website pantone.com for about $75. Your local agricultural service provider, such as a county extension office, may have a color chart that you can borrow. Using a soil knife or trowel, collect at least 5 small soil samples from an area that represents the same soil type and management history. Gather the soil from the surface layer, 0 to 8 inches, and combine all the soil samples in the bucket, mixing well. The soil should be moist and hold together, but not wet. Moist soil will not glisten in the sunlight. If the soil is too dry, use a spray bottle to moisten it. Take a handful of soil and make a ball. In the sunlight, hold the ball of soil behind the holes in the Munsell 10YR chart. Match the color of the soil to the color in the value section of the chart that runs vertically. Value represents lightness and darkness. Note the number associated with the value. On the Munsell 10YR chart, this will be a number between 2 and 8. After a value has been determined, looking only at the row containing that value, match the color of the soil to a chroma color chip. Chroma color chips run horizontally, and on the Munsell 10YR chart will include numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 8. Chroma represents color intensity. Record the value and the chroma. On the 10YR diagram card, find the hue that corresponds with the color and chroma. For example, 3, 1 corresponds to very dark gray. Record the color. If you have been building organic matter in one area, it might be fun to compare soil color between that location and a location with different management conditions. Soil microbes release sticky compounds that help bind soil particles together into bigger soil clumps, also known as aggregates. The microbiometer kit contains a solution that releases the microbes from the soil particles. After the microbes are separated from the soil, their biomass can be measured. The microbiometer system utilizes a mobile app to read the color contrast of the microbes against a special test card and provides the resulting microbial biomass. The mobile app also provides step-by-step instructions, which is very handy. However, I found that the timer within the app did not function correctly on my phone. For that reason, I recommend using the timer on your phone or another timekeeping device. Lastly, keep in mind that the microbiometer instruction manual notes that biochar applied within 6 months before testing may affect results. For this test, you will need a microbiometer field test kit, which can be purchased at www.microbiometer.com for $135, a soil knife or trowel for collecting soil samples, a small bucket or container, and a smartphone with the microbiometer mobile app installed. Microbiometer field test kit includes extraction vials, powder packets, a sifter, a plastic bag, a syringe, a metal spatula, a whisker, pipettes, test cards, a backing card, and a sheet to help you interpret your results. Before beginning the test, make sure you've downloaded and installed the microbiometer mobile app. Using a soil knife or trowel, collect 10 small soil samples from an area that represents the same soil type and management history. Gather the soil from a depth of 2 to 5 inches and combine all the samples in a small bucket or container. The soil should be moist, ideally 2 to 3 days after a significant rain or irrigation event. After collecting soil, I like to take the kit to a table or other comfortable spot where I can lay things out. Prepare the extraction liquid. Tear the powder packet open and empty the contents into the extraction vial. Using the small capped measurer, add 9.5 milliliters of water to the vial. Select a handful of soil from the mixed soil in the bucket. Sift the handful of soil using the included sifter. Shake it to remove debris and collect the sifted soil in the provided plastic bag. Measure the soil by filling the soil sampler syringe to 1 milliliter with the sifted soil. Compress the soil against your finger to 0.5 milliliters, removing any excess from the end, and eject the soil into the extraction vial. The accuracy of your readings depends on consistency of soil volume and compaction. Compacted soil, especially clay, must be broken up using the included metal spatula. Allow the tube to rest in the hole in the kit. Insert the whisker, turn on, and allow to mix for 30 seconds. You do not need to touch the whisker while it's mixing. Allow the soil to settle. This occurs in 2 stages. After mixing, allow the liquid to rest for 5 minutes. Tap the bottom of the tube on a hard surface to coax floating debris to settle. Allow to settle for an additional 15 minutes. Soil particles will settle to the bottom, creating a microbial suspension above. Next, take a sample of the microbes. Use a small pipette to draw up liquid from about half an inch below the surface. Squeeze the pipette before entering to avoid blowing bubbles. Avoid any floating debris and foam at the edges. Carefully apply 3 drops to the sample window of the test card. Allow each drop to soak in fully before applying the next. Analyze with the app within 2 minutes. Analyze with the app by placing the test card on the appropriate spot on the backing card included in the kit and reading with the app. The app will first ask you to name the sample, then it will automatically image the test card and provide a reading. Align the blue square on the screen with the square on the test card. When correct imaging is occurring, the blue square turns green. A sample details screen will appear, allowing you to enter sample-specific information for your records. Record the microbial biomass value and the corresponding interpretation located within the app and on the sheet provided. Soil microbes such as fungi, bacteria, algae, and protozoa consume organic matter containing carbon and exhale carbon dioxide. We can measure the amount of carbon dioxide these microbes breathe out using a Solvita field kit. Soils that are more biologically active will release higher levels of carbon dioxide. The level of activity varies throughout the year with temperature and moisture. If you intend to take annual measurements, make sure to record details about your location, field conditions, and the weather, and replicate the test under similar conditions. To perform this test, you'll need a Solvita Basic CO2 test, which can be purchased from solvita.com. It costs about $99. The Solvita field kit includes jars, testing probes contained in foil packages, a color chart for interpreting results, and an instruction manual. You'll also need a soil knife or trowel to collect soil, a small bucket or container, a sieve to remove debris from the soil, a container to place the soil in once it's been sieved, a soil or meat thermometer, and a kitchen scale. Record the soil temperature at each sample site. Using a soil knife or trowel, collect multiple small soil samples from an area that represents the same soil type and management history. Take at least 3 samples. Gather the soil from about a 4 to 6 inch depth and combine in the bucket. Handle carefully, trying not to crush or grind the soil. Gently sieve the soil to remove rocks, roots, or other debris. Measure 90 grams of soil using your kitchen scale. Open the foil pouch and without touching the gel surface, insert the test probe into the soil in the jar. If the gel is separated from the plastic probe, place it back onto the probe without touching the gel with your fingers. Screw the lid onto the jar and record the start time. Keep the jar at roughly 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Temperature control is important to maintain since it impacts the activity of the soil microbes. After 24 hours, remove the probe and compare the color of the gel to the color chart included with the kit. Note the number that corresponds to the color and look at the interpretation table, table 1 in the instruction manual, to understand your results. If the soil temperature when sampled was above or below 70 degrees Fahrenheit, adjust the results using the conversion factor found in table 2 of the instruction manual. Soil hardness is a measure of how much resistance to penetration exists in the soil. Soil hardness impacts how easily roots, mycorrhizal fungi, and other life can grow and move through the soil. Compaction occurs when large pores are packed closely together, often as a result of tillage or the use of heavy equipment, especially on wet soils. Compacted soils can lead to runoff, erosion, poor water holding capacity, slow drainage, and can keep roots from accessing nutrients. A tool known as a penetrometer gauges penetration pressure in soils and the readings are recorded as pounds per square inch, or PSI. Most plant roots are unable to penetrate soils with a penetrometer reading of 300 PSI or greater. This test is most useful in fields where tillage or equipment traffic is more frequent, or any other space more likely to have compaction. This test should be performed 1 to 3 days after a significant rain. To perform this test, you will need a penetrometer, which can be purchased from an online store such as Gemplers.com. Alternatively, you can try reaching out to an extension office or other agricultural service provider to see if they have one they can loan you. The penetrometer has a gauge at the top, a shaft separated into 3-inch sections, and 2 tips to choose from. Use the smaller tip. Press the penetrometer into the soil slowly at a rate of about 1 inch per second. The penetrometer shaft has notches every 3 inches. As you drive the penetrometer through the soil, read the gauge as each 3-inch section of the shaft enters the soil. Make sure you are reading the section of the gauge corresponding to the size of the tip you are using. Record each of your readings. Take readings in 3 locations that are representative of the area and calculate an average. Finally, note the depth at which the probe reaches compaction. This is where you can't drive it any farther into the soil. Thank you for joining me on this soil testing journey. Lots of love and joy to you as you use these tests to better understand the condition of your soil and how to create a habitat for all the life within it.